Hello, everyone. My story began before I was 16, and it was a very important year in my life because I decided to leave school. And I left school because I really suffered in school. And when I left school, I didn't know to read and write. I dyslexic, dysgraphic. This is the reason that also my English is not so good. But when I left school, I decided that I must build a different school, to build a new school. And it took me 10 years, and I built a new school. I call this school Democratic School. Why democratic? Because in the traditional school, I cannot find the connection between what happened in the real life and in school. I was confused. What is this idea of schooling? What it's doing there? Why all the time people tell me what to do? How this is preparing me to life? So I built a new kind of school. And in this school, we have today 600 students. From 4 years old to 18. And in this school, every student chooses his learning plan. He chooses what he wants to learn, how he wants to learn, with whom, when. Of course, it's mixed ages learning. We don't understand why people decide to learn by age. Think about that, I will tell you now. Everyone is down of 30, go to the other room. What's the idea of learning by age? And then we are not only individual, we are as a community. So we make the community run as a democratic process. We have a parliament meeting. In this parliament meeting that we have every week, we decide about all the rules of the school. And we also run the school by day by democratic communities. Today, what I tell you now, it was 33 years ago that I began to do it. Today, we have more than 2,500 schools that call themselves democratic school in 60 countries. And today, we also understand something very deeply that I cannot see it in the beginning. That the democratic idea, democratic education idea is the missing piece of democracy at all. Think that most of the country today in the world call themselves democracy, but they adapt the education process that prepare people to undemocratic living. So in most of the world, children from 4 years old until 18, someone tell them what to do, how to do, and check them if they do it. And this is preparing them to when they are 80 and then tell them, now choose your life. It's not working. We build a process that make us feel not free. We believe that freedom needs to come from when you are 1 year, 4 years, 5 years, and growing until you are 18. But it's not like this and then jump up. So in this point, we understand that we not only want to work in democratic schools, and we begin to work in traditional school and prepare them to implement the ideas of democratic education. And so I go today all over the world and I show them this presentation, and I will show you the presentation. Think that this shape represents all the knowledge that exists in the world. And these people that you see here is us. We are different. Every one of us different. We have different talent and different motivation. Think that this is the most beautiful things that exist in the world, that we are different. I'm sure that part of you believe that God created us. Other people believe that nature created us, and another people here don't know who created us. All the three answers is wonderful. But who created us decide that we are different. Think about God. Sit and think how to create a human being. Now to be 8 billion different human, let's do it in one stance. And if he was decided to build us at the same, I was standing here now on the stage, and all of you were Yaacov. And this is boring. And then we go to New York, and we see everyone is Yaacov. And we go to Moscow, and everyone is Yaacov. The most exciting things that is we are different. But something happened in the middle of the industrial age. What happened? People built a lot of factories. One of the factories that people begin to think about was schooling. And the major idea, oh, maybe it's a mistake that we are so different. Let's make from all of us the same. And they built this factory box. And in this box, small box, they want to put this, a group of 20, 30, 40 children together in the same age. No one knows why, but let's do it in the same age. In the same time, with the same materials, with the same teacher. And then they push all the people inside. Get inside. Okay, everyone, get inside. You with the piano, get inside. And you, it's not the science of the co-curriculum, get inside. And you're doing art totally of not the co-curriculum, get inside. And that's how it's looking the schools today. And I was 10 years teacher. And it's not only difficult to students, it's also difficult to us, the teachers. And you understand that if you make zoom into this box, you see that this is not a box. It's a pyramid. And the excellent student in the top and the loser in the bottom. And you understand that this is the biggest lie of education. Because the excellence, it's not excellence, and the weak is not weak. They are weak only in the box. The people here, in the battle can be unbelievable in this area of knowledge. So what we do in democratic education, I don't want that my student be in the top. I don't want. I think if I will educate my student to be in the top, I make dangerous to the world. Because then they need to compete with their student, with their friend, and then from the other people from the other city, and then from the other states. Yeah, this is the terrifying things. And why to learn this subject? I want to learn them to find their uniqueness, where they can find their excellence. And it can be out of the box. It can be in this area, in this area, in this area. And you understand that the knowledge area is doubling itself every half year. And the box is standing the same time in the same position. So in this situation, we take the children out of the box and looking for their place that they feel that this is their self. They feel good. They can find their uniqueness. My good friend, Sir Ken Robinson, called this place the element. The element, it means that your talent connect to your motivation. In this point, you have the most success option to success in your life. You can success in your life not if you are do like everyone. and compete with them who will is in the top. You can success in your life, that's the idea of element, if you find your uniqueness. And the option that we live now in the internet give you a lot of abilities to be uniqueness in different things. Like you see, we say today here in the first presentation. And but this, to find uniqueness of every child is very expensive. So I need a lot of teachers. And it's very expensive. To this reason, we need to use alternative energy. And what is alternative energy in education? Alternative energy in education, it's an energy that we don't use. For example, the knowledge of the student. No, student not come empty to the school and only need to teach, learn from the teachers. They come with a lot of knowledge. The teacher come with a lot of knowledge that not only what they teach. Parents have a lot of knowledge. Free program in the internet have a lot of knowledge. So what we are doing, we move the school from the old traditional school that get money from the government or from parents and make with the money of them education, to place that use the old alternative energy to make totally different schooling. In this position, we don't need the box. We can learn in all the knowledge area. And in this situation, everyone is a teacher and everyone is a student. We know from research that the best way of teaching, learning something is to teach it. So when we're talking about innovative education, and it's something very important when we talk about technology. New technology must to connect to new pedagogy. Because if we connect the new technology to the old bad paradigm of education, it's dangerous. And what we are talking now is moving from a pyramid to a network, and from this box that I call it the encyclopedia box, because encyclopedia was a great idea to put all the knowledge in one book, but it's of the 18th century, not today. And to walk in the all area of knowledge that we can find in the internet. So how we do moving from a pyramid to a network? This is the old traditional teacher. I call it 1.0. And he comes with a blue good materials and he pushes it to everyone. The new teacher come and know that the student come with uniqueness, with their color. And then he need to learn who is there. And when he learn who they are, he say, oh, he can teach him, and he can teach him. And he make a network in the classroom. In this situation, we build a new kind of school. The new classroom in Israel, and it's like a football team. That everyone have a different role, and together they have a common achievement. In this situation, we say all the students and the teacher are teachers, and the classroom have a common achievement. What it means, we have such a graph in all the classrooms, and we have training game, training game, training game. Training is one teach another, peer learning. Game is the average of the results of what the classroom achieve. So the classroom have a grade of mathematics. So we do it and we have like a biofeedback of the classroom. But okay, so this is the way that we move from pyramid to network. But how we teach at school, how the student can learn everything that they want. Because in this area, they can learn, in education 1.0, they can learn only what the teacher know. The limit of the learning is what the teacher know. But how we can do it in a different way, in this reason, we begin to use the MOOC. We begin to use it 6 years ago. But the problem with the MOOC is, and you know that today a lot of universities make MOOCs, all the universities in the world today. The problem is when you take the MOOCs in the computer at your home, only 4% success to finish. In this point, we come to the Minister of Education in Israel and tell him, okay, you remember Classroom 2.0? Let's connect it with the MOOC. Let's do MOOC and student will teach student. And this, we begin with 88%. Today we are more than 90% successful. So you can see here, for example, this is a Muslim school in Israel. They have computer, they see chapter, they have card. Green, it say, I understand, I can teach. Red, it say, I don't understand. Yellow, I have question. And then they say chapter, they put a card, and they begin to teach one another until everyone is green. It's become very informal. Here we do it with teacher in Moscow. Also, you see the cards. Here, I bring this picture because this teacher decided to learn in MOOC, EPOP. Because it's not only academic, you can learn everything by MOOC if you do it in this way. In the end, I want to say something very, very important. It's not, as I said before, it's not only technology. We need to understand to where the pedagogic going. And we're moving from teaching-based school, from a school that teaching is in the base, to a learning-based school, place that the learning is in the central. We don't want that children will finish school and they're looking at their teachers. We want that students will finish school and they feel that they can learn everything. Everything, because they have the ability to learn everything. And this is the major idea of what I want to talk with you today, so thank you.
Thank you, Yaacov.
Thank you.
And thank you so much for your inspiring presentation. I really like the mentality that you meet these students with, the uniqueness of them supporting that. Can you say something more about how does MOOC support that uniqueness in your perspective?
Yeah, I will tell you, I hope that I can do it in English. One day I come to a classroom in one of the city in Israel, and this classroom learn only by MOOC. They choose MOOC, and then they learn it as a team, and then choose another MOOC. And I ask them, what you learn now? And they say, oh, we learn in medicine something that connect to this area. I don't know how to call it.
I don't know either. Yet. Yeah.
I tell them, what? How you come to learn about this area? And one of the students say, okay, my grandmother have a poetry, and I ask my friend if they want to learn about this operation. And I tell them, you can bring me the MOOC. And I see the MOOC, and it was a MOOC of medicine of MIT.
Okay.
And they was 40 years old, around. And then I asked them, I was like shocked a little bit because I'm also a human being and I have ideas. And I asked them, tell me, you think that you can learn everything that you want in the world? And they say to me, you ask us as a team? And I say, yes. And they say, yes, as a team we can learn everything that we want. And in this moment, I understand that this is something that I look for all my life. The goal of education, that children will finish school, that they will feel that they can learn everything that they want, and this, from my point of view, a free person. Yeah. This is something that connects to what I believe about democracy.
Amazing.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Yaacov. Please give him a hand. Thank you.